Hello students, today we are going to start our new chapter, chapter 3, multiplication, division and their application. So today in this video we are going to learn multiplication fact. Now let us understand multiplication with an example.
Concept of multiplication with the help of these little fish. There are 4 fish bowls. There are 2 fish in each bowl. To get the total number of fish, we add the number of fish in all the 4 bowls. That is 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 is equal to 8. There are 8 fish in all. Here, we repeatedly added 2. 4 times. This is called multiplication operation. Multiplication is repeated addition. We can do this multiplication operation in an easier way. Let's see how. There are 4 fish bowls. Each bowl has 2 fish in it. Now, 4 times 2 is 8. So, there are 8 fish in all. Let us use the multiplication symbol to write this statement. This is called the multiplication sentence. It can be read as 4 multiplied by 2 is 8. 4 times 2 is 8, or 4 twos are 8. Also used for the numbers in a multiplication sentence. The number that is multiplied by another number is called multiplicand. The number by which another number is multiplied is called the multiplier. The number obtained by multiplying 2 numbers is called the product.
Multiplication. Let us learn about the properties of multiplication that will help us to solve problems easily. Let's learn the basic properties of multiplication. There are 5 properties involving multiplication. They are multiplication by 0 and 1, order, grouping, and distributive properties. The 0 property of multiplication. The product of any number multiplied by 0 will be 0. Multiplication by 1 or identity property of multiplication. When we multiply a number by 1, the product is the same number. Order or commutative property of multiplication. The product of 2 numbers remains the same, even if we change the order of the numbers. Grouping or associative property of multiplication. When 3 or more numbers are multiplied, the product is the same, regardless of how the numbers are grouped.
Solve some questions from your textbook. Now here, we will multiply 4 digit by 2 digit. Now, first we will multiply 4876 by 92. So, first we will multiply the whole number 4876 by 2. So, let us multiply. 2 6 are 12, carrying over 1. 2 7 are 14, 14 plus 1 is 15. 5 carrying over 1. 2 8 are 16, 16 plus 1 17, carrying over again 1. 4 2 are 8, 8 plus 1 is 9. This is our partial product. Now, we will multiply by 9. As 9 is in the tens place, we will put a cross and then we will start with the next place. So 9 6 are 54. 5 will be carried over and 4 will come here. 9 7 are 63. 63 plus 5 is 68. 8 will come down and 6 will be carried over. 9 8 are 72. 72 plus 6 is 78. 8 again down, 7 will be carried up. 9 4s are 36, 36 plus 7 is 43. Now we got two partial product. Now let us add them. 2 plus 0 is 2, 5 plus 4 is 9, 7 plus 8 is 15, 9 plus 8 is 18, 3 plus 1 is 4 and 4. So the answer is 4,48,592. Now the next sum. Here we will multiply 5,983 by 604. So again we will multiply 4 by all the numbers. 4 by 5,983. 4 threes are 12. 2 carrying over 1. 4 eights are 32 plus 1 is 33. 4 nines are 36 plus 3 is 39. 4 fives are 20. 20 plus 3 is 23. Now we will multiply 5,983 by 0. 0 means we have already studied the property of 0, that if we multiply any number by 0, the answer will be 0. So when we multiply 0 by 3, the answer will be 0. 0 by 8 is 0. 0 into 9 is 0. And 0 into 5 is 0. So the second line will be 0. Now we will multiply with 6. Now 6 is in the third place in the hundreds place. So we will put 2 cross and then we will start multiplying. 6 threes are 18, carrying over 1. 6 eights are 48 plus 1 is 49, carrying over 4. 6 nines are 54. 54 plus 4 is 58. 6 fives are 30. 30 plus 5 is 35. Now we will add them. 2 plus 0 is 2. 3 plus 0 is 3. 9 plus 8 is 17, carrying over 1. 3 plus 9 is 12. 12 plus 1 is 13, carrying over 1. 8 plus 2 is 10. 10 plus 1 is 11. 5 plus 1 is 6 and 3. So the answer is 36,13,732. Now children, let us do some story problems given in exercise 3G of your book. Now first question is, Shirin can read 27 pages of her book in 1 hour. How many pages can she read in 7 hours? Now children, remember one thing. When information of 1 is given and more they are asking, we have to multiply. As here they have given that she can read 27 pages in 1 hour. Now how many pages she can read in 7 hours? So number of pages read in 1 hour is 27. Therefore the number of pages read in 7 hour is 27 into 7. We will multiply 27 into 7. The answer is 189. Therefore, thus Shirin can read 189 pages in 7 hours. Now, question number 2. You will try yourself. It is also direct multiplication question. And we will do the fifth question. Because the rest of the questions are based on division, which we will be doing in the next video. Now, question number 5 is, again, Anaida finishes her homework in 45 minutes on Sunday. On Saturday, she needs 4 times that amount of time. How much time does she spend on homework on both the days? Now, children, we will find out that how much work she is doing on Sunday. So, how much time she is taking on Sunday? So she is taking 45 minutes on Sunday, and on Saturday they gave us the information that the time taken on Saturday is 4 times the time taken on Sunday. Whenever you are getting this word times, 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, it means we have to multiply. So whatever time she is taking on Sunday, 4 times extra time she is taking on Saturday. So we will multiply 45 by 4 and we will get the answer as 180. So she is taking 4 times more time, means 180 minutes to complete her homework on Saturday. Now the third thing what they have asked is how much time, total time she spent on homework on both the days. Total time means we will add. When we will add 180 plus 45, the answer is 225. So total time she took to complete her homework on both the days is 225. Children, do these questions, try some questions from your book, and if you have any problem, any doubt, any difficulty, let me know. Thank you.